champion!
What the?
Booker! That's Cora Jade!
What up, y'all? This is your boy Ace here. And welcome to Afternoons Delight. Let me tell y'all something. It is a pleasure to be making this video right now. I was so worried about Cora Jade, man. When we didn't see her, what was the last time she was on there? January 24th, right? She was in the middle of a program against Lyra Valkyra. And then that's when the Nikita Lyons parking lot incident took place, right? That was our great addition. That was probably still my favorite episode of NXT this year, you know, since the calendar year, 2023. That was my favorite episode right there. And then since then, it was like a mystery how Cora Jade just was missing, just went missing. And we never did find out until recently that she had an injury that she sustained. But for a while there, I was really worried about Cora Jade because I was like, is something going on? But I always felt good because her boyfriend, Bron Breakker, never said anything. So I felt like, and then she never had anything like on Instagram where it looked like something happened to her. So I figured either she's out with an injury or she's just taking some vacation time. I don't know. But she's been out the last 2 months. And it's great because I felt like there was a chance if she was coming back. I felt like there was a good chance that she would come back after Stand and Deliver. And then when I saw the promo, they played a vignette on Saturday doing Stand and Deliver. I said, uh-oh, she's close to coming back then. And she's back. It's not like Nikita Lyons said she had a serious injury, because we're not going to see Nikita Lyons probably, I don't want to say the rest of this year, but like at least probably into the fall at the earliest, because her injury is like a year-long injury. So I knew it wasn't going to be that long, you know, for Cora Jade. But to see Cora Jade come out tonight, man, bro, now we can move forward, because I've been making so many videos talking about Cora Jade and what they can do with Cora Jade. Now that she's back, we can finally get to some shit now. Like, we can finally see some stuff. Like, she was doing so well as a heel before this injury, bro. Like, just to see her come back, man, this is amazing. I still don't even know what type of injury it was either. That's the crazy part. Still don't know what type of injury it was. If y'all know what it was, let me know in the comment section. But let's get to what happened tonight. So basically, Indi Hartwell, y'all know she's the new champion. She had a match against Zoey Stark, who challenged her for the title because Zoey Stark did not believe that she was worthy of being a champion. She thought she was a joke. And Zoey Stark has beaten Indi Hartwell before, so she's cocky. She had her shot. Indi Hartwell beat her in a fruit roll-up, basically. And then that's when Tiffany Stratton came out to talk about how there was a key spot in the Standard Deliver match where she knocked her off the ladder, and that's what really helped Indi Hartwell win, because she was the only person that could have stopped Indi Hartwell from winning the title, since everyone else got, you know, she did that flip off the apron and stuff like that where the girls didn't even try to catch her. But then, after Tiffany Stratton was talking, we saw out of nowhere someone dressed in all leather returned, and it was Cora freaking Jay who attacked Indi Hartwell. I was like, there go my girl right there. There go my girl right there. And Cora Jay has a chance to be, her and Tiffany Stratton right now have a chance to take over where Mandy Rose left off. Also JC James too. They have a chance to take off where she left off, bro. Any of them three girls, bro. I might even put Tatum Paxley in there, but we're going to talk about Tatum Paxley because she fought Ivy now. We're going to talk about her in the last video I'm going to do this week on NXT. But Cora Jade, bro. Zoey Stark too. Zoey Stark. But no, more like, I'm going to say more like Cora Jade, Tiffany Stratton, because they kind of could pick up where she left off. Because the only thing I've been saying about Cora Jade is that Cora Jade just needs a heel stable. She needs a faction that she can lead. She needs some henchmen. And I think that's where they need to go with her. I want to see that this year, man. I want to see, because that's how you can help her get the title too. realistically against Indi Hartwell, you can have her beat Indi Hartwell, bro, for the title. I kind of still kind of want to see Tiffany Stratton with it too, but here's what I think. I think one of the two are going to get it. I think what's going to happen is the first person who challenges her between those two, they're going to lose. The second person will win. That's what I think is going to happen. And that's how you kind of get Roxanne Perez back into the title picture. She could face a heel later in the year and get it back. Get the strap back. Maybe I think Cora Jade might be the best option because she has a rivalry against Roxanne Perez, and Roxanne can get it off of her. And then you can have Cora get it back from her when Roxanne goes to the main roster probably next year, right? So you can do that whole program. And one last thing I want to say about what happened in that little situation. When Cora Jade walked to the back, she looked at Tiffany Stratton and she said, "She's mine." I was like, oh, I like that. I like that. I like seeing the two heels. And this is why I said NXT has a golden opportunity to do what they didn't do with Mandy Rose, what they should have did with Mandy Rose. There should have been a power struggle at the top, right? This is what I would do. I will have Cora Jade and Tiffany Stratton lead their own stables. Have Tiffany Stratton lead a smaller group with three girls. Put three girls with Tiffany Stratton. Maybe put Tatum Paxley in there and another girl. Put them with Tiffany Stratton. And Tiffany Stratton leads a different version of Toxic Attraction, but similar though. Make it like a beautiful, like the, remember the beautiful, y'all remember the beautiful people in TNA with Angelina Love and what was her name, Velvet Sky? Bro, and then Madison Rain came in. They should do something like that with Tiffany Stratton, bro. Like all beautiful people, put them in a stable. And then Cora Jade's stable will be like just a bunch of random heels. Like you put Zoey Stark in there. If Zoey Stark doesn't go to the main roster soon, you put her in there. Alexia Lopez, maybe put just any sort of heels that they got that they could grab. You put Tatum Paxley in there too, but just grab some heels and put them with Cora Jade and make it a power struggle between Tiffany Stratton and Cora Jade. That'd be fire, bro. That'd be fire. In the next video, we're going to talk about Lyra Valkyra, because I'm glad that they're going to continue this program between Lyra Valkyra and Cora Jade, because I thought it was really good before they left. We're going to talk about that next. And when I make my video on Cora Jade, I'm making a standalone video with Cora Jade. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the faction stuff. Then I'm going to talk about what did I say I was going to talk about with Cora Jade in that video? So the faction, damn, it just slipped my mind real quick. Don't y'all hate him when that happens, man? But it'd be like, whatever you thought of, it was like right there, then he just lose it. Hold on, let me see if I can think before I leave this video. It was something else, man. God, what it was, bro. I can't believe I forgot that fast. Damn. Give me 10 more seconds to see if I can think of it. Hold on. Let me think. Let me think quietly. I got a block, man. I got a block. I can't think of it right now. And it's going to piss me off because I'm probably going to think about it in the next video. I'm probably going to remember it in the next video. But go ahead and give me y'all comments, man. Throw y'all comments down. Go ahead and get this video a like. Hit the like button for me out. Share the video. Subscribe to the channel. And make sure y'all watch that video that I'm going to do on Cora Jade. Whatever it was, I'm going to be talking about it in that video. So I'll probably make that video next week, though. It probably won't be out this week. It'll probably be out next week. But thank y'all for... And we're supposed to hear from Cora Jade again next week. So... Definitely gonna cover that on NXT. Thank y'all for watching. After news to like.